A very good afternoon, sir. My name is Dipan Dasgupta. We are going to present an audio book, which is a Python-based mini project created by us. My fellow teammates are Aditi Mallik and Devanjana Bashak. So let's see what is Python. Python is basically a high-level interpreted object-oriented language whose specialty lies in the fact that is strong and dynamic. Unlike the other common languages like C or Java, which are strong and static. So why are we using Python? Here we have some points. At first, readable and maintainable code. Python is simply written in English language, so it is very easy to read and understand. Secondly, we have compatible with major platform and system. At present time, Python is supporting many operating systems. It allows you to run the same code on multiple platforms without any replacement. Thirdly, we have robust standard library. The standard library allows you to choose from a wide range of modules according to your needs. Each module enables you to add functionality to the Python application without written additional codes. Next, we have many options, source, framework, and tools. Then it is very easy to use Python in complex software development like machine learning using Python. Python even makes it easier for you to perform coding and testing simultaneously by adopting test-driven development approach. So let us see what is an audiobook. We are quite familiar with the term audiobook. We can easily listen to it in our phone or laptops. So an audiobook is basically a book being read out to you. Our aim is to create a simple audiobook which can read any PDF using Python text-to-speech modules. Now I would like to request Aditi to continue from here.
Thank you, Dipan, for giving this beautiful brief introduction. Okay, now the question is, can Python speak? No, Python can't speak. But we can make our computer to speak with Python using text-to-speech process, and the given text will be speak in common English language by your computer. We have used two Python modules, namely PyTTSX3 and PyPDF2, to implement this TTS process to create our project. Now, see, what is PyTTSX3? It is basically an abbreviation of Python text-to-speech version 3. It is a platform-independent library. The main advantage of using this library is it works in offline mode, unlike other libraries. And it is compatible with both Python version 2 and 3. Using this module, we can change the speed of speaking, volume level, and the volume of the speech, etc. Now we come to the other module. The next module is PyPDF2. It is actually a fork of original PyPDF library. It is a PDF library that we can use for splitting, merging, cropping, and transforming pages, etc. in our PDF. According to the PyPDF2 website, we can also use PyPDF2 to add data viewing options and password to the PDF. We can also use it to extract documents from our PDFs. By using these two modules, we have created our project. Now I would like to request Devanjana to proceed further.
Thank you, Aditi. Now let us have a look at the working procedure. So first, we will import the two modules, PyTTSX3 and PyPDF2. Then we will open the PDF using the inbuilt open function. Next, we will read the PDF using a function from the PyPDF2 module called PDFFileReader. Then we will count the total number of pages in the PDF, create an object of the Python text-to-speech module, Next, we will run a for loop from a specified page number of our choice to any other page number, preferably in the last page. We will get the particular page, extract the text from that particular page, convert the text to speech, and run it. Now, let us have a look at our code. So as you can see, we have implemented the same thing as I have said in the algorithm. First, we have imported the two modules. Then we have opened the PDF, but before opening this, we need to ensure that we have first saved the PDF in our project, otherwise it will throw an error as it will not be able to recognize the PDF. Then we will count the total number of pages and print it. Then we will initialize dpyttsx3 module by simply creating an object using the init function, and we will say a greeting message. Then we will start a loop. The starting index of the loop is from 2 to the last page. So basically it will start reading from the third slide of the PPT. Then we will get the particular page and extract text from that page. And in line number 28, it will simply pick up that text and then we will run it. Now the portion of the code from line number 13 to line number 26 is optional. As mentioned earlier, we can change the rate, volume or voice of the speech. So there are two standard voices, male and female. The default voice is actually male, and inside the for loop we have changed the voice from the default male voice to female voice by simply giving the index 1, because it is a standard for the module that 1 indicates female and 0 indicates male. And we have also increased the rate. The default rate is 200, but over here we can see we have increased it to 210, and we have also adjusted the volume of the speech. Now in line number 8, the greeting message and the presentation, these two will be read out in two different voices, because the first one will be read out in a male voice and second will be read out in a female voice. So let's have a look by running the code.
A very good afternoon, sir. Welcome to our audiobook project.
Why are we using Python? Readable and maintainable code. Multiple programming paradigms. Compatible with major platforms and systems. Many open source frameworks and tools. Simplify complex software development. Adopt test-driven development. 3. The concept of audiobook is quite popular, as we can easily listen to any book or PDF either on our phone or laptops or any home speaker system.
So next we will see what is our objective of using this audiobook. Why have we made this in the first place? Now the first advantage is it improves our pronunciation and fluency. Listening to audiobooks improves our reading and speaking accuracy. While the narrator narrates the book, we can easily notice and learn the way he or she is pronouncing. The second advantage is it improves our focus and attention span, and hence improves memory and boosts our mental health. It is very easy to get lost and distracted while listening to an audiobook, so as a result it would require your full attention and concentration to listen to one, and overall it improves our memory and mental health. The third advantage is it is beneficial for people with visual impairments. Now it is a blessing for people with poor eyesight, or those people who are blind, or people with reading disorders like dyslexia, hyperlexia, and makes their otherwise discomfortable reading experience a pleasure. Now the fourth advantage is the teacher. It is very helpful for teachers to teach in this present scenario of online classes. The teacher can easily run an audiobook and the students viewing it can listen to it. The fifth advantage is it avoids the problem of strained eyes from prolonged reading. Now, in this present situation, for our students, we do not have the subject books and it's not possible for us to physically go to college and get it. And many of us fear buying online. So what we do is simply search for an online PDF and read it. But for how long can we look at a computer screen or a mobile screen? It will eventually hurt our eyes and then we will start to get headache or migraine. So overall, it's not a very smooth and pleasant experience. So audiobooks provide a very good solution to this problem. You can simply run the audiobook, sit back and relax and listen to it. So this is our team. My fellow team is Aurithi Moldik and Dipan Dashgupta. So we have reached our conclusion now. Thank you, sir, for giving this opportunity. We got to learn many new things while doing this project. Thanks to your initiative. Thank you.
Excellent, excellent. Can you do it in female voice, please? Can you try on a female voice? You have ready-made female voice.
So we have done the female voice. I mean, the presentation is being read out in a female voice, and that greeting message is being read out in the default male
can you,
voice.
Can you do once more?
This yeah, time? Yeah, sure. Okay.
A very good afternoon, sir. Welcome to our audiobook project.
Why are we using Python? Readable and maintainable code. Multiple programming paradigms. Compatible with major platforms and systems. Many open source frameworks and tools. Simplify complex software development. Adopt test-driven development. 3. The concept of audiobook is quite popular, as we can easily listen to any book or PDF either on our phone or laptops or any home speaker system. Audiobooks are voice recordings of the text of a book that you listen to rather than read. It can be exact word, 4 word versions of books, or abridged versions. Our aim is to create a simple audiobook which can read any PDF using Python text-to-speech modules. 4. What is an audiobook? We can make the computer speak with Python. Given a text string, it will speak the written words in the English language. This process is called text-to-speech, TDS. See how we can implement the TDS process. We have used two modules in our project, namely PyTTSX3, PyPDF2, 5. Can Python speak? PyTTSX3 is a text to speech conversion library in Python. The main advantage of using this module is that, unlike alternative libraries, it works offline and is compatible with both Python 2 and 3. PyTTSX3 is a cross-platform TDS library which is platform independent. It provides the provision to change the speed,
thank you,
volume level, or the voice of the speech. We can also store the recording to a file. The included TDS engines are SAPI file.
Okay, excellent project, excellent. Excellent. Okay, excellent project. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.